ancient prophecies foretold the coming of the birth of God's anointed Savior who brings peace upon earth. He shall be born unto us, and God will be with us, and we shall find him in the cave of Bethlehem. O star of Bethlehem, you shine with brilliance in the sky, to lead us all to God's own Son who will save all mankind. The lowly town of Bethlehem in the Judean hills will be exalted from above by God's own gift of love. He shall be born unto us, and God will be with us, and we shall find him in the cave of Bethlehem. With jubilation angels sing glad tidings of the birth, proclaiming glory in heaven for God's Son born on earth. As humble shepherds watched their flocks, these tidings were announced. The Savior's born in David's town, in swaddling clothes he's found. He shall be born unto us, and God will be with us, and we shall find him in the cave of Bethlehem. O Magi from the east, you bring gold, frankincense, and myrrh, and searching for the newborn king, these gifts you now offer. O Joseph, you protect and watch the infant Son of God. In solitude you ponder your commitment to our God. He shall be born unto us, and God will be with us, and we shall find him in the cave of Bethlehem. The Holy Virgin Mary now fulfills the will of God.
Like those you remember no more, cut off as they are from your hand. You have laid me in the depths of the tomb, in places that are dark, in the depths. Your anger weighs down upon me. I am drowned beneath your waves. You have taken away my friends and made me hateful in their sight. Imprisoned, I cannot escape. My eyes are sunken with grief. I call to you, Lord, all the day long. To you I stretch out my hands. Will you work your wonders for the dead? Will the shades stand and praise you? Will your love be told in the grave, or your faithfulness among the dead? Will your wonders be known in the dark, or your justice in the land of oblivion? As for me, Lord, I call to you for help. In the morning, my prayer comes before you. Lord, why do you reject me? Why do you hide your face? Wretched, close to death from my youth, I have borne your trials. I am numb. Your fury has swept down upon me. Your terrors have utterly destroyed me. They surround me all the day like a flood. They assail me altogether. Friend and neighbor, you have taken away. My one companion is darkness. Lord, my God, I call for help by day. I cry at night before you. Let my prayer come into your presence. Sojourn your ear to my cry. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Now and ever and forever. Amen.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory
to you, O God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Yeah.
Captive of Christ our God, and have raised our up in you.
humanity by your life and resurrection. Glory to you, O beloved of the soul.
Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever. Amen.
Of Leo Tocos, we sing your praises, for you were virgin before conceiving. And remain the virgin at the giving birth. And since you have given birth to our salvation, Jesus Christ, you have become a treasury of assistance for all who seek resurrection and eternal life. Therefore lift us up from the depths of our transgressions, for we place our hope in you.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. May all that is in me bless his holy name.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all the gifts from him.
Pardons all your sins, heals all your infirmities.
Ransoms your life from corruption, and crowns you with his love and mercy.
Fills your longing with what is good, and your youth is renewed like the eagle.
The Lord performs deeds of kindness and vindication for all the oppressed.
Made known his ways to Moses, and his will to Israel's children.
The Lord is the one of compassion and mercy, long-suffering and manifold love.
His contention is not forever, nor will his anger always last.
He has not dealt with us as the sins of man, nor does he repair evil deeds.
For as high as the heavens stand over the earth, so far as the Lord is, has extended his love for those who fear him.
As far as the east is from the west, so far as he removed our sins from us.
As kind as a father is to his children, so is the Lord to those who fear him.
For he himself knows well how we are born. Remember, we are only made of dust.
Man, his days resemble grass. As a flower of the field, so shall he bloom.
But let him breeze pass over him, he is gone, and never shall he know his place again.
But the love of the Lord is from all eternity, and to all eternity for those who fear him.
And his justice is upon the children of children, of those who keep his covenant, and remember his laws to obey them.
The Lord has established his throne in heaven. Over all things his kingship is supreme.
Bless the Lord, allowing his angels, you strong and mighty ones to obey his word, but hearing the sound of his decree.
Bless the Lord, all you his powers, his attendants who obey his will.
Bless the Lord, all you his words, in every place of his dominion.
Bless the Lord, O my soul.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever. Amen.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
For us all, from you, the Savior of the world, to bless. Then vainly do we live.
your children, children, like friends around your table. Rejoice and be happy and offer them to Christ. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, now and
Jesus, who love is sinless,
We bow to your cross, O Christ, and we praise and glorify your holy resurrection. For you, Lord, our God, and we know no other, we call you by name. Come on, you faithful. Let us bow to the holy resurrection of Christ. For behold, through the cross, Christ has flowed over. Always blessing the Lord, let us praise his resurrection. By enduring the cross for us, he destroyed death by death.
Have mercy on me, God, in your kindness, in your compassion, Father, of my offense.
Oh, asking more and more for my guilt, and cleanse me from my sin.
My offense is truly unknown. My sin is always before me.
Against you alone have I sinned. What is evil in sight I have done?
That you may be justified when you give sentence, and be without reproach when you judge.
Oh, seeing guilt I was born, no sinner was I conceived.
Indeed, you love truth in the heart, and in the secret of my heart teach me wisdom.
Oh, purify me, then I shall be clean. Who wash me, I shall be whiter than snow.
Make me hear rejoicing and gladness, that the bones you have crushed may thrill.
From my sins turn away your face, and blood out all my guilt.
You are marked free for me, O God. Put a steadfast spirit within me.
Do not cast me away from your presence, nor deprive me of your Holy Spirit.
Give me again the joy of your help. With a spirit of fervor, sustain me.
That I may teach transgressors your ways, and sinners may return to you.
Rescue me, God, my helper. My tongue shall ring out your goodness.
O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall declare your praise.
For in sacrifice you take your delight, burnt offering for me you would refuse.
My sacrifice is a contrite spirit, a humble contrite heart you will not spare.
In your goodness show favor to Zion, rebuild the walls of Jerusalem.
Then you will be pleased with lawful sacrifice, burnt offering slowly consumed. Then you will be offered young bulls on your altar. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Through the prayers of the holy apostles, O merciful One, cleanse us of our many sins, now and ever and forever. Amen. Through the prayers of the Theotokos, O merciful One, cleanse us of our many sins. Have mercy on me, God, in your kindness, in your compassion, blot our quiet offense. Jesus is risen from the tomb, as he foretold, and granted us everlasting life. And great mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Forgiveness, forgiveness for repentance and tomorrow acknowledge confession of sin. You have revealed to us the repentance of Prophet David and led your pardon. Master, have mercy on us who have fallen into so many and so great sins. Have mercy in your kindness and in your compassion on our offenses. For against you we sinned, O Lord, and know the depths of our hearts, and who alone have the power to forgive sins. Up here are you have created for us, who sustained us with the spirit of fervor, and give us the joy of your help. Do not cast us away from your presence, but in your goodness and love for all, grant that we may offer a sacrifice of righteousness and an oblation on your holy altar and tell our last prayer. Do the mercies and goodness and love of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your all-holy, good, life-creating Spirit, now and ever and forever.
Amen. I will walk in my love. It will be filled with the Holy Spirit. And I will offer my praise to the Queen of Heaven.
for all holy God, and virgins maiden, virgin maidens precede her.
Most holy Theotokos, save us.
The pre-eternal counsel of our pre-eternal God arrives at fulfillment when you, O most immaculate mistress, come forth to dwell in the Holy of Holies as the abode of the Word.
Most holy Theotokos, save us.
Godly parents and Eve, who are to become the Mother of God, into the Holy of Holies, to make your habitation, thereby fulfilling the promise they made when they offered up entreaty, O pure one.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
Mistress, strengthen the weakness of my heart, and make it steadfast, for it has been shaken by the passions, that with faith and love I may call you blessed, for the ever blessed and most immaculate one.
I will look in my mouth. It will be filled with the Holy Spirit, and I will offer my praise to the Queen Mother. I will celebrate in joy. In my rejoicing, I will sing of His wonders. Celebrate your precious memory of great glory.
passions, and up, up to the most pure heights of dispassion, you have all gloriously shown forth rays of healings, having made your abode in the never waning light of the kingdom of
let's drop the sweetness which takes away all the bitterness of our soul.
Most high, save us.
Strange is your conception, strange your nativity, O all pure virgin. Strange your coming forth and your entering of the holy place, and strange are your all glorious works, past recounting and understanding.
Most high, save us.
Wherefore you became the mother of the Word.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever. Amen.
Setting all my hope on you, O May, I plead to your compassions. Show forth my fallen soul to be untouched by the malice of the demons, and unweakened by the floods of pleasures. Upon the beauty of the angels and listened to their sweet chanting. He lived a long and God-pleasing life and died peacefully in the 9th century in Constantinople, his soul taking up his abode in the joy of his Lord. St. Proclus, Patriarch of Constantinople. Proclus was a disciple of St. John Chrysostom. In the year 426, he was consecrated the Bishop of Cyzicus, and in 435 was chosen Patriarch of Constantinople. He governed the Church of God as a prudent hierarch. During his tenure, two significant events occurred. The first was the translation of the relics of St. John Chrysostom from Comana to Constantinople at the desire of both the Emperor and the Patriarch. Emperor Theodosius the Younger was then reigning with his sister Pulcheria. The second event was the great earthquake in Constantinople and the surrounding countryside. Many of the largest and most beautiful buildings were destroyed by this terrible earthquake. Then the Patriarch, with the Emperor, many of the clergy, nobles, and people, came out in a procession of supplication. As they were praying to God, a child was miraculously lifted high in the air until he was out of sight. Then he returned and was lowered gently to the ground. Asked where he had been, the child replied that he had been lifted up to heaven among the angels, and that he had heard the angels sing, "Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us." Upon hearing this, all the people in the procession began to sing it, and the earthquake ceased immediately. From that time on, this beautiful hymn was adopted by the church. The child soon reposed and was interred in the church of St. Irene. In all, St. Proclus served as a hierarch for 20 years and reposed peacefully in the Lord in the year 446.
Through the prayers of our Venerable Father, Gregory the Decapolite, and our Holy Father, Proclus, O Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us. Amen.
The three moons walk courageously upon the blinking furnace, preparing to worship the Creator rather than created things, and they sing our hymn joy. Blessed are you and praised above all, O God of our fathers. Most holy Theotokos, save us.
The holy temple received you as a radiant sun, shining forth a radiance of salvation upon the ends of the earth, O pure virgin, who shall contain the Son of God.
Most holy Theotokos, save us.
Let us all clap our hands, beholding her who knew not wedlock, bearing the images of deliverance, for by the hand of an angel is she fed, who shall ineffably give birth for us to the bread of life.
Most holy Theotokos, save us.
All the souls of the righteous beneath the earth proclaim you, O golden dove, and they declare you to be her who bears the calm which ends the noetic deluge, and who dances with piety in the holy of holies.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever. Amen.
As you are beautiful, you gave birth to the beauteous one who restores our ugliness to its pristine beauty, O most immaculate maiden. To him do we chant, "Blessed are you, O God of our fathers."
Of the Most High, let his
except the pure maiden whom we have conceived with valiant soul. For her sake shall deliverance come to pass. Let us lead her into the holy temple, crying, Bless the Lord, all you works of the Lord.
Most high, therefore, does save us.
The Lord alone is blessed, cried the priest. Those who made declaration to us clearly now show us the gates of life and the divinely inhabited palace in which the Messiah, the King of all, shall make his abode. To him all the earth cries out, Bless the Lord, all you works of the Lord.
Most high, therefore, does save us.
Behold, O most wise elder, Anna said with reverence, Receive the splendor. Receive with splendor the most comely maiden whom God has given and prophesied as she alone shall bring to a material end what was foretold. With the other prophets cry out, Bless the Lord, all you works of the Lord.
Most high, therefore, God save us.
Now I have most clearly realized, the elders said with understanding, a tree will grow in the midst of the temple, which will truly put forth the divine fruit, who shall lead into paradise those driven out because they ate the food of corruption, who shall cry out with joy, Bless the Lord, all you works of the Lord.
Most high, therefore, God save us.
The elder clearly spoke words of ineffable teaching. O pure virgin maiden, your soul shall make its habitation in this divine temple. For fed by an angel, you shall give birth to the angel of great counsel to whom we chant. Bless the Lord, all you works of the Lord.
Let us bless the Lord, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever. Amen.
With joy we chant to you with the cry of Gabriel, O pure maiden. Rejoice, you who alone are the cause of joy for all. Rejoice, cleansing of our souls, in that you gave birth to the deliverance of us, who render praise and hymns to him. Bless the Lord, all you works of the Lord.
Let us praise, bless, and worship the Lord, singing and highly exalting him above all forever.
From their seats and exalted the humble. He has filled the hungry with good things,
the rich he has sent away empty.
For on above is the cherubim, and beyond compare, for grace and the seraphim, who the Virgin gave birth to God the Word, you truly deserve to be magnified. He has received Israel as a servant, being mindful of his love, as he spoke to our fathers, to Abraham and to his seed forever. More honorable than the cherubim, and beyond compare, more glorious than the seraphim, who a virgin gave birth to God the Word, you truly the Theotokos be magnified.
Praise to your glory beyond reach, for you are the one true God, full of mercy. For all the heavenly powers, praise and be in glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever.
Of Christ, let us adore the Holy Lord.
Oh, praise him with sound of trumpet, praise him with lute and love. What shall we give to the Lord for all he hath done for us? To save us, God has dwelt in our midst. The Word has become flesh because of our corrupted nature, and he has taken up his abode among us. The benefactor reaches out to us in our ingratitude. The Redeemer comes to us in our servitude. The Son of Justice descends to those in darkness. He who is beyond suffering is near to the cross. He is light to those in hate and light to those in death. To all mortals he is the resurrection. Therefore we cry out, O our God, glory to you. Praise him with timbrel and dance, praise him with strings and pipes. Come you faithful and assembly, let us honor with hymns. Her who was most worthy, one of a barren mother, the divine bride and mother of the Creator. And let us go forth with virgins and lambs to meet her, as she enters the Holy of Holies of the Temple. Clashing of cymbals, let everything that lives and that breathes give praise to the Lord. Having gathered words of the Spirit from the wedding bells like diverse flowers, let us joyously weave wreaths of praise for the Virgin and Mother of
their goal. However, troubled souls. He said, the Lord Jesus has risen.
The author of light will have Christ is good and loves us all.
Amen.